This is the part 2 of chapter 2 of Bhagavad Gita, where Shri Krishna is talking about introspecting and going within ourselves. All our scriptures talks about self-realization. But what is exactly self-realization? You must have heard about the Ashtanga Yoga of Patanjali, the 8 Yoga Sutras. So what are those? Those are Yam, Niyam, Asan, Pratyahar, Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi. So Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi is the last 3 stages of self-realization. Dharana is concentration, Dhyan is meditation. And when you learn to do these 2 things, Samadhi comes, which is the self-realization, automatically. You don't have to strive for it at all. It comes from the grace of Guru or from the grace of God. Although you can start with whatever practice you love to do, just inculcate a practice of being in the present moment. That is enough. Because when you are present enough, you become observant of your thoughts, you become observant of your own habits, and everything else naturally starts to fall in place because you become aware. Your self-awareness increases and all the other things will fall in line one by one, and you don't have to strive for it. People really talk about following a particular lifestyle. When you are on a spiritual path, you have to do this, you don't have to do that. You should not have alcohol, you should not have non-veg. But all of these things should be something which should be inculcated through ourselves. It should not be imposed on us. And when you learn to be in the present moment enough, and when you reach a state which is of higher consciousness, these things won't even matter to you. You will be doing all those things naturally and happily. And this is what Hinduism tells us. It never imposes any rules on us. It asks us to do a self-introspection. And when we do it, we naturally start to purify ourselves. We also start to nullify our past karmas. And I'll give you an example how. So when you are in present moment doing any sort of activity, let's not talk about meditation at all because it's very difficult for people in the beginning state. So how you can inculcate habit of being in the present moment when you don't know it? Let's say you are working on a particular task. Your focus should be to remind yourself all the time that this is the time I have given to myself to do this task, and I will not think about anything else. I'll only think about this task, and that is how it will get accomplished within a stipulated time. At that very moment, what will happen is your mind will drift to different areas of mind. Maybe it will drift to some other task which is also pending. And when it does go to the other task which is pending, you will start to become uneasy. All the uneasiness, all the anxiety, all the stress comes when you are not in the present moment. So it's the opposite of being in the present moment and not being in the present moment. If you're in the present moment, you're happy. And if you're not in the present moment, you're stressed, you're uneasy, maybe you're worried, maybe you're fearful, maybe you're anxious, maybe you're angry. So all the other emotions which are not related to happiness, you remind yourself that this is not my natural state of being. This is not me. This is my mind giving me problems to solve. Don't ignore those thoughts till the time you have settled. For example, the way I was talking about right now, that you're working on a particular thing, your awareness drifts away into another task, gently bring it back to the present task that you're working upon. And maybe write something down for future tasks or maybe other tasks that you're thinking, that what is it that is worrying you. And when you write that particular worry down, or maybe something related to that task down, you are releasing that energy into a paper and you're putting it aside. Then come back to the present moment. It is for those people who really struggle very hard and want to improve. But most of the cases, people don't struggle that much. It's just the habit pattern that we have created. So if you can just remind yourself to be in the present moment, you can instantly resolve your stress and anxiety. Now let's talk about how I was saying that you can also resolve your past karmas. For example, you had a fight with your brother or a sister or maybe parents or somebody else or a friend. Now, if there is an unresolved emotional issue in your life, my guru says that if you don't resolve it, it will keep on recurring in your mind, and that awareness of yours will keep on going into that area of the mind. What is your awareness trying to tell you? Your awareness is trying to tell you that you have some unresolved emotional issue which you need to solve first. Only then will you be able to settle. So that is one negative karma that you have created, but you don't know how to solve it. That's why you're just struggling very hard, but you want to come back to the present moment. It will never happen that you can come back to the present moment. The only thing that will happen is you will become more stressed, more anxious, and it will not lead you anywhere. So when you become observant of your own thoughts, when you become self-aware, our awareness is telling you a lot of stories which needs to be heard. And when you hear it from all your heart and you try to solve them, if you're not able to solve them, you can also take help from someone that this is the issue and I don't know, I'm thinking about it again and again, I just don't know how to get rid of these struggles. Talk to a wise person, I'm sure he or she will be able to guide you. And if not, then just write that down on a paper, set it aside for some time and say that I'll get back to you when the time is right. It works like magic because you are not leaving it unattended. You are addressing it by some way. So this is how your karmas gets resolved or dissolved when you learn to be in the present moment. Everything that you do in your life, starting from the morning till the night and when you sleep, everything is teaching you something, and whatever is it that we are manifesting within ourselves is manifesting in our lives. Whatever thoughts we have in life, if it's not purified, our external life is just a reflection of our thoughts. Our external life will mirror exactly what is going on inside of us. So either you work towards cleansing your thoughts and raise your vibration and go, just keep, try to keep your awareness in the uplifting areas of the mind, you will start to notice that your external conditions are also changing, and it does change. I have seen that in my life. And when you start incorporating it in your daily life with each task, eventually your life starts to get aligned to the goals that you have created, and you're able to accomplish more because you become clear of what your goal is. First of all, you become clear of what your purpose is, and you know how to be happy while pursuing your goal. People say that it's the journey, not the goal, and that is true when you know how to be in the present moment, when you can enjoy doing just any task in your life. So this is also coming from chapter 2 of Bhagavad Gita. Shri Krishna is asking every one of us to do self introspection, to know what is the soul, to know who am I. Ask this question to ourselves, who am I? And it's extremely peaceful to read.